Hydrocephalus is a buildup of the cerebral spinal fluid inside of the brain. People are most familiar with it in the pediatric population, and there it's about 1 in 1,000, most common in premature infants. But what people don't realize is that it is a similar problem in adults. Currently, the only treatment for hydrocephalus is brain surgery. Our ultimate goal is to find a drug that we can use to treat hydrocephalus. I'm Bonnie Blazer-Yost. I'm a professor of biology in the School of Science here at IUPUI. And what we're studying in the brain is what are the processes that cause the production of cerebral spinal fluid? An analogous question would be, what goes wrong? And is there some step where we can intervene with a potential drug? The DoD is interested in this, as you might well imagine, because of traumatic brain injury. The active duty military, of course, are most prone to the post-traumatic form of hydrocephalus. The DoD's veteran population is, like all populations, aging, so the normal pressure hydrocephalus is important to them as well. In talking with our colleagues, we realized that there's probably a lot of commonality. We thought it would be nice to have a center to bring all of this together. It has become a point of collaboration across campus. The neuroscience units on campus, particularly the medical school, have shown interest. We're hoping that the center is a conduit for bringing people together here in Indianapolis, because having our clinical colleagues join us is very, very powerful to have multiple views of hydrocephalus and how we might approach treatment options.